bulb doesn't have the ability to give light, but both the presence gives that.
Thought is happening.
Prakash, nene bandilala? ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ. ಥಾಟ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡ್ಲಿಕ್ಕೆ ಹೋದ್ರೆ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ನೆರಳು ಹಿಡಿಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗತ್ತಾ? ನೆರಳು ಹಿಡಿಯಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಹಾಗೆ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಡಲಿಕ್ಕಾಗಲ್ಲ, ಅದು ನೆರಳು, ಅದು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಅದು ಮಾಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರು? ಏನು ಏನು ಇಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಹಾಗೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನ್ ಸಂಬಂಧ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ? ಆಗತ್ತೆ, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್.
ಇವಾಗ ಅನ್ಸುತ್ತೆ ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿದಕ್ಕೂ ಹೋಗ್ತಿವಿ, ಅವರದ್ದು ತುಂಬಾ ಆಗೋಗಿತ್ತು, ಆದ್ರೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಇದಾಗ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಆದ್ರೂ ಇಷ್ಟು ಇದು ನಂಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ತುಂಬಾನೇ ಈ ಶಾಂತಿ ನೆಮ್ಮದಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ವಿವರವಾಗಿ ಅವರು ಹೇಳಿಲ್ಲ. ಸುಮ್ನೆ ಒಂದು 5:30 ಏಳುಗಂಟೆ ತನಕ ಅಂತ ಒಂದು ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿ ಅಕ್ಷರ ಇದು ಮನೆ ಭಗವದ್ಗೀತೆ ಇದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಓದ್ಕೋತೀವಿ, ಓದ್ಕೊಂಡ್ಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದಿಷ್ಟು ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮಾತಾಡ್ತೀವಿ. ಆದ್ರೆ ಇಷ್ಟು ನೆಮ್ಮದಿ ಇಷ್ಟಿದ್ರು ನಂಗೆ ಎಲ್ಲೂ ಸಿಕ್ಕಿದ್ದಿಲ್ಲ. ನಂಗೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಬಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ನೆಮ್ಮದಿ ಸಿಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ನಾನು ಯಾಕೆ ಈ ತರ ಮಿಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಂಡೆ?
So, how does it make a difference to you in your life?
In my life, Salpa, I'm feeling peaceful.
Peaceful. Salpa.
And I'm going towards that.
Okay, very good.
I know it is, it will take time, but I am on the way.
Time is also a thought. Time doesn't exist. The moment you think of time, the time appears.
Yesterday's class it was very interesting, you know. I could feel that nothing was real because it's a thought. And when I don't think of this particular this thought, I don't see it. I see something else. So that was clear.
Very good. Gayatri?
Yeah, all thoughts are unreal.
Thoughts are unreal. But they appear to be so real. And that's another thought actually.
ಅದು ಭೂತಾಕಾಶ ಅದು ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರು ಗುರುಜಿ. ಅದರೊಳಗೆ ನಮ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಉಲ್ಟಾ ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೀವಿ, ಚಿತ್ತಾಕಾಶ ಚಿದಾಕಾಶ ಅದು ಬೇರೆ ಕಲರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾಡಿ ತುಂಬಾ ಚೆನ್ನಾಗಿ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಯ್ತು. ಆಮೇಲೆ ಒಂದೇ ಕಲರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ತೋರಿಸಿದ್ರು ಅದು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ಲಿ.
Very good. You have to be very careful about what is there. Okay. Pradiba?
Thoughts, so, Madhidali, can you explain
Time is a perception. Huh?
ಆಮೇಲೆ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟೊಂದು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೇ ಸೂರ್ಯ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಚಂದ್ರ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಎಲ್ಲ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ಲೈನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು.
ನಿಮ್ ಚೇರ್ ಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಚೇರ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ, ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಚೇರ್ ಹೊರಗಡೆ ಚೇರ್ ಕಿಡೆ ಚೇರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ,
ಅಂಡ್ ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಡು ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಮಾಯಾ.
ಯಾ, ಹೌ ಡಸ್ ಮೇಕ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಲೈಫ್?
ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಡು ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್, ಐ ಆಮ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್, ಸೋ ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಅವೇ ಫ್ರಮ್.
ಸೋ ಇಫ್ ಎನಿಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರಬಲ್ ಬೈ ಥಾಟ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಥಾಟ್. Okay, can you hear it?
That it's very tough to get a human life, so you should utilize it.
Very good. Make a lot of money. Every single minute you should make money. And use it properly. Right? Not only making money, why you should make money and how to use it. That's important.
Giving.
Not giving.
Giving.
The money should not be given.
No, not so easily.
Not so easily. ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿದೆ ನೀವು. ಓಕೆ, ಮನಿ ವೈಲ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್, ದರ್ಸ್ ಟೂ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ದಾನ, ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವ್ ಟು ಸಂಬಡಿ ಹೂ ವಿಚ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಬೆಗ್ಗರ್, ಡೋಂಟ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೊನೇಷನ್. ದೆನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಯತ್ನ. ಯತ್ನ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಾನ. ಇನ್ ಯತ್ನ ಯು ಗಿವ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಗ್ರೋ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್. ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್? ಸಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, somebody has you know, ಬೆಳೆ ಬೆಳೆಸಿದ್ದಾನೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯಸ್ ಗ್ರೋನ್. ನಾವು ಹಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ ಸೇ 1 quintal ಆಫ್ ರೈಸ್. ನಾವು ಇಫ್ ಹಿ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ 1 kg ಆಫ್ ರೈಸ್ ಟು ಎ ಬೆಗರ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ದಾನ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ 1 kg ಆಫ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಟು ಅನದರ್ ಫಾರ್ಮರ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ಪುವರ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಯತ್ನ. ದಿಸ್ 1 kg ನೋ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಇಟ್, ರೈಟ್? So then here, then actually you are actually increasing
his
thing. Not only him, you are not. See, there are two ways of donation. One is called fish, give a fish to somebody who is hungry. Another is teach a fishing to somebody. So then he will make a living. So when you give donation, you have to differentiate between dana and yadna. You should do yadna. Do something so that the person grows and he helps others grow.
So he doesn't need that to keep coming.
He doesn't need that to keep in. Not only that, he will help others also. Right? So always you should go for yadna and a small amount to dana. And the, understood the difference between yadna and dana, right? So, for example, I learned from my guru. Okay? Now, I am teaching you people. Okay? Is it dana or yadna?
Yadna.
Because you people will take it to some other people. It grows. This is yadna called Brahma yadna, highest yadna. Okay? There's no yadna greater than the yadna which I am doing.
Now, adhe thoughts bagge helidhe, tumbane thoughts bartha irutte mindige, adre ella at a time onde bara sadhya ante helidru
neevu. Haudu, tumba thought bartanu one thought bartashte.
Adu disappear aadmele matte inondu bara sadhya irodu.
Haudu.
ಅದೇ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್, ಅದೇ 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 ರಿಯಲ್ ಅಲ್ಲ ಅದು, ಅದ್ರ ಇನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಎರಡು ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ತುಂಬಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ವಿ.
ತುಂಬಾ ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಅದೇ ಭಗವಂತ. ನೀವು ಭಗವಂತ ಭಗವಂತ ಅಂತ ಯೋಚನೆ ಮಾಡಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ, ಅದು ಭಗವಂತ ಮಾಯ, ಅದು ಗ್ಯಾಪ್ ಬಂದ್ಬಿಡ್ತು ಅಂತ ಆಡ್ಸ್ಕೊಂತ.
ಸರಿ, ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೇ ಭಗವಂತ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಅನ್ನೋದು.
ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರಲ್ಲಿ?
ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಿನ,
ನಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರು
ಶಕ್ತಿ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಂಡು ಕೂತಾಗ ನಾವು ಥಾಟ್ಸ್ ಬರ್ತಾ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಆದ್ರೂ ಅದು ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದಾಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಮಾಯ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಅದೇ ಆ ಒಂದು ಇದರಿಂದ ನಾವು ಪ್ರಪಂಚವನ್ನು ನೋಡುವಾಗ ಅದು ಎಲ್ಲ ಶಿವಮಯ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಮ್ಗೆ ಅದೇ ಅಂತ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗುತ್ತೆ. ಶಾಂತಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಕಡೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಶಾಂತಿ
ಕಾಣುತ್ತೆ.
వస్తుంటుంది పోతుంటుంది, దాంట్లో ఉండిపోతే సఫరింగ్ హ్యాపీనెస్ ఉంటుంది. అది వదిలేసి నేనెవరు అని నా దాంట్లోకి వెళ్ళిపోయి ఉంటే పీస్ఫుల్గా
శాంతి
శాంతి. ఇంకా తర్వాత ఏదన్నా వచ్చినా ఒక పిక్చర్, అలా వెళ్ళిపోతున్నట్టు నో సఫరింగ్.
దేర్ జస్ట్ ఇమేజెస్ కమింగ్ అండ్
మూవీ
మూవీ
70 మూవీ
నాట్ బాదరింగ్
నాట్ బాదర్ అన్లెస్ యూ వాంట్ టేకింగ్ యాక్టింగ్ యాక్ట్ కర్నా చాహియే.
No.
You want to become hero, heroine, go into the movie. No, you want to buy a ticket, then you can watch, watch.
No, 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 yes, only I want peace.
Peace, okay.
Yes, the concept of thought was very good.
Yeah.
So, also it led us to understand there's no future, no past. There's no present.
There's no mukti, there's no bondage also.
There's only presence.
There's only presence.
That presence you find in the silence. So definitely I think I'm going into more and more silence.
Very good. I am going into my silence. I am silence.
I am silence.
Okay.
Then the other thing is there are two queries, questions from my side.
Okay.
One is this Kali is time and Shiva is that Chidabhasa.
Shiva is Jiva.
Jiva. I wanted that whole thing to be explained a little more. That is one. And then...
What do you want explanation there?
What is it that... What is the message we are getting out of?
Okay.
That is one. The other thing is this Sahaja Samadhi.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to Samadhi. Is there anything beyond Samadhi?
No. The Samadhi... See, Samadhi is recognition of your true nature.
Yes.
As silence. That's all. Now, once you recognize it, it's like you recognize the rope, snake as a rope. Then after that, you have to live in that. So if you live longer, more, so you will be in that state. If you live less, it will again go back to the Maya. Now, what is beyond Samadhi is a transcendental state, which is called Nirvikalpa. So, which means actually there you lose the awareness also, which is actually happens in deep sleep. Yogis try to get it artificially. I am saying don't worry about that artificial thing. Stay in that Sahaja Samadhi. You have understood, and deep sleep itself is Nirvikalpa Samadhi. You understand. Otherwise, you have to struggle a lot to get Nirvikalpa Samadhi. That's a lot of effort goes into making a Nirvikalpa Samadhi. So that effort is not necessary to put. More and more you stay near Sahaja Samadhi, your vasanas will drop. Okay? So actually recommendation is Sahaja Samadhi rather than Nirvikalpa Samadhi for a Jnana. Okay?
There's nothing more to try out.
Yeah. So what happens if you repeatedly read a Vedanta scripture, they will say Nirvikalpa Samadhi comes very often. Nirvikalpa Samadhi is exactly sleep. Okay? Nothing more than sleep. Except that they go into sleep, okay, with knowledge. With the awareness. Means at will they are able to go. Okay, there are two things happen there. Nirvikalpa Samadhi. One is awareness goes. Sometimes the prana also goes. The prana also moves. When the prana moves, heartbeat stops, breath stops, and all those things. But real Vedanta Jnana, so these things are not required for realization. Okay. People can achieve it. You put a little bit more effort, I can show you how to achieve it. But not required. We don't have to become superhuman, right? We become normal human, integrate spirituality into our life without struggle. That's the purpose. So there is a lot of practices which can lead you to Nirvikalpa Samadhi. But the question is, do we need to that? So Vedanta teaching is you don't need it. So then where the Vedanta says Nirvikalpa, it is not about Samadhi. It is about your state. You are Nirvikalpa. Okay, yogis think that I have to become Nirvikalpa. There's a difference. I have to go to Nirvikalpa Samadhi is yogi's thought. But Vedanta teaching is you are Nirvikalpa. Recognize you are Nirvikalpa. There's a difference. Right? So what happens is that as you do this, okay, that presence inside you grows outside also. It's not just confined to within you. Without you also the presence will be there. Because that sense of body is there. That's why I am feeling peace is within me is the question. But it's not within me also. It's without me also. That is Sarvam Kaluya Brahma will come. Okay. So as you become intensely aware, you will end up in Sarvam Kaluya Brahma. So that is the end. Right now, this is the beginning. Recognizing yourself is beginning, Aham Brahmasmi. But Aham Brahmasmi has to culminate in Sarvam Kaluya Brahma. Okay.
And that example of Rama was also very good. First you see the form, then you see the essence of the form,
And then you come back and then you see that in everything that
yes, that's exactly what happens in Sahaja Samadhi. Okay, exactly what happens in Sahaja Samadhi. So now people do it with lot of effort, they go into Nirvikalpa Samadhi. The breathlessness, so Vasanakshaya, ela bartade? What is breathlessness, so Vasanakshaya, what is heartbeat stopping, I'll tell you. It looks very fantastic for the people, but
it's not required.
Okay, and people want to achieve it because that involves, that gives them a satisfaction.
And that's again a vasana.
I've achieved something.
Some residual vasana.
Okay, yogis will struggle for that. I'll show you what yogis will do. Okay, but then it's all unnecessary. Your natural state is your natural state. Why you would struggle for that? That's why it's sahaja.
Superimposition of the body on Atma, when it is understood and it is removed, it gives you Sahaja Samadhi.
Samadhi.
So once that is...
You don't have to remove.
It automatically gets.
You don't have to remove. You shift your attention from body to Atma, is over. See, this is another problem. I have to remove the body to realize Atma is not required.
Okay.
Okay. So what happens is that yogis, especially, they insist that my heartbeat has to stop, okay, to realize Atma. That means I have to drop the body. No. Vedanta teaching is not that. See, Vedanta teaching is Atma is Advaita. Okay. That means if you say body is an obstacle for you, it's not Advaita. Body, it becomes Dvaita. So that's where dropping the body is not required. Shifting the attention from body. That's required. That's different.
Right.
Okay. Then the moment you say body has to be rejected, then you come to say Dvaita.
Dvaita.
Okay.
So, Narayana alone exists. And the consciousness in rest is Narayana and consciousness in movement is Shakti. Shakti. So, I mean, four questions are in itumba clarity. And while riding back home, a thought arose, why can't all the terrorists in the world simply sit and do the Sahaja Sthiti meditation?
No. The terrorists are required to chase you to the classes. Otherwise, you are sitting in comfortable. The world is a beautiful place. Okay? Terrorists, mosquitoes, husband, wife are required to go to the Sadhana. You know?
Violence
is not the problem. Duality is the nature of the world. Okay? And also look at Shiva Purana. All asuras and terrorists will go and take a blessing from Shiva. Okay?
And he
only grants the grants. Vishnu doesn't give.
Yeah.
Vishnu will be waiting for terrorists to come and kick them. Whereas Shiva gives the boon. Because the fear and tension in the world will drive you to Atmadana. Then he can destroy your ignorance. If you don't have fear and tension in the world, where will you come to Atmadana? So there is a Shiva is destroyer.
Okay, so that is a driving force.
Driving force. Bekado. That no point of time in the world there was first actually when Vishnu world got created, Madhu Kaitaba asuras came. Madhu Kaitaba. Okay, that time no terrorists were there. Okay, the world Vishnu was then Madhu Kaitaba asuras were there. Imagine the situation. That means that is the beginning of the world.
Okay.
Till today, the duality will be there. Good and bad will be there. The bad drives to good to the good to the better, and better will go to beyond. Vade vekala. the good and bad will not vanish from the world. If bad vanishes from the world, good also will vanish. The duality is required. Why bad is there? To make better good people better. Okay? Good people better and better people beyond. Realize. That's why the bad is there. Now always you should be wondering why Shiva is giving boon to demons. He is giving because that's a part of life. There's a part of cleaning up process.
And another thing which you told was also good, that the difference between a sannyasi and a jnani. Sannyasi drops only mind, whereas a jnani drops both mind and eye.
Sannyasi drops mine and trying to get drop I.
Trying.
That means doership is there. Okay.
And a yati is the one who has taken a formal sannyasa and trying to drop the I. Sai Baba, I didn't get the full answer from you.
We'll get the answer. ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ.
ಈಗ ನೀವು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿಸ್ಕೊಳ್ತೀರಿ, ಅದು ಅದೇ ಮಾಯೆ ದೇವರೊಳಗೆ, ದೇವರ ಮಾಯೊಳಗೆ ಅದು ಗೊತ್ತಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಈಗ ಅದು ಧ್ಯಾನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ಮೇಲೆ ನೀವು ಹೇಳಿದ ಪ್ರಕಾರ ಭೂತಾಕಾಶ
ನನ್ನ ಒಳಗೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಯಾರೊಳಗೆ?
ಆತ್ಮ.
ಆತ್ಮ ಸಾಕ್ಷಿ ಭಗವಂತ
ಚಿದಾಭಾಸ
ತಣ್ಣಗಾಗಿ. ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್, ವೆರಿ ಗುಡ್. ಸೊ ದ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್ ಎಲ್ಲ ಒಳಗೆ ವ್ಯಾನಿಶ್ ಆಗುದಿಲ್ಲ. ಇಫ್ ಒನ್ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋಸ್, ಅನದರ್ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಕಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್. ದ ಟೆರರಿಸ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, terrorism and negativism is there in the world for the positive to grow. Okay, and so that you become, so the devas and asuras, the battle has been ancient, it will not end, and I'll tell you today who are devas and who are asuras, some more detail now. Okay,
so Guruji, are you saying that there won't exist a possibility where everyone is realized?
No, it's a schooling system, education system. When does your university stop working?
When everyone graduates,
there will be nobody graduate, there will be some more people will come, no? Right? You know, understand this is called a universe, you understand? Okay. Universe is a university, that's, you understand? The word university has come from the universe, you know? Huh? In the universe, there will be always a flow of people. Okay. Lower level animals will become higher level animals. Higher level animals will become higher level animals.
Okay?
Okay? So millions and billions of human life, lower forms, they are waiting for a human birth to graduate. A continuous process of graduation, it's not endless, it doesn't end.
Okay.
It doesn't end, not even after the destruction of the universe, it'll again start from the beginning, because lot of people are waiting in the queue for evolve.
Okay.
What about the same generation of people, like same generation of people, can they all become realized?
No, there's not generation actually. So how old are you?
10.
Oh. 10 is in this life, that's your body. Okay? So you have taken many, many lifetimes. There is lifetimes of learning is there. That lifetime of learning is coming to this life. So like that, Jiva is not just body. It has matured through many, many lifetimes. The learning happens in many, many lifetimes in this university called universe. Okay? So now, you are classmates of 10-year-old classmates. Okay? Some of them may have gone to 50 lifetimes, some of them have gone to 100 lifetimes. They are different classes, even though they are sitting in the same classroom. Alright? They will take their own time to evolve. Suddenly, everybody will become, not become one. Peaceful. I'm saying law of nature, if there is sunlight, there is a darkness. If there is a darkness, sunlight is there. If there is a good, there is a bad. If there is bad, there is good. If good vanishes, bad also vanishes.
But, if there be a chance, there will be no bad at all.
So then the universe will stop functioning. The university will close. That's actually, it won't happen because, see, you are looking at only human being. There are 64 million life forms. They are trying to evolve into human being.
Like ants and mosquitoes.
Ants, mosquitoes, they are gradually evolving into human being. So human beings, some of them realized go out. Some of them will join. It's a continuous flow. And those people have to, those who have come out, they have to learn the lessons of good and bad. They have to evolve. It's a long, long, long cycle.
So how did this...
It is part of the universe.
It's part of it. And the bad is not really bad. Is not really bad. Sir, killing is good or bad?
Depends on the
situation.
No,
wait. Killing is good or bad?
No, it depends upon with what attitude you are. Why are you...
Do you recommend killing or not?
Huh?
Do you recommend killing or not?
Depends upon what purpose
you
destruction has to take place in nature.
Do you kill mosquitoes?
Yes.
Huh? Is it good or bad?
Good.
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 So, good and bad is a relative viewpoint. From the universe point of view, there's no called good and bad. From the universe point of view, there's some cleaning up happening, something new coming up.
So now you call that as bad if some terrorist kills somebody. But if you kill a mosquito, mosquito is terrorized by you. Then you say it's good.
I feel I'm giving moksha to the mosquito.
This is evolving.
It's evolving to a different extent. So it is getting more.
So what happens is this good and bad in the universe is absolutely real, relative. Okay. So now people in Lanka worship Ravana actually.
Yes.
Okay. They think that he is a great king. He brought a lot of wealth to Lanka. For us, he terrorized people. So it's a relative viewpoint, where you stand. Universe doesn't take relative viewpoint, sir. Universe says absolute viewpoint. Okay.
Guruji, yes. So how did this process of duality start?
There's no duality.
Yeah, okay.
See, the duality is the moment you try to perceive it. I mean, very simple to say. Very, very, not a very complicated answer. There's no answer we can give.
Okay.
The universe is consciousness.
Okay.
Which doesn't know itself. It can't know itself also. It's infinite.
Yeah.
The moment it tries to know itself, the duality starts. I mean, what happens is that, let us say, knife can cut a potato, knife can cut a banana, knife can cut any mango or anything.
Mm.
Can knife cut itself?
No.
So the moment knife cuts to itself, it becomes knife becomes distorted.
Mm.
Knife cannot cut itself, but knife, let us say, has the ability to cut it, trying to cut itself. Then knife gets twisted. Understand? The universe is trying to perceive itself, to know itself, then it gets twisted into duality.
But okay, if it is consciousness which is knowing.
Mm-hmm.
So how can knowing try to know?
No. See, it is knowing has nothing to know.
Yeah.
It is peaceful.
Yeah.
Okay, nothing to know.
Yeah.
But knowing has ability of conceptualization. Knowing is not just knowing, it has the ability of conceptualization.
Okay.
Okay, now this conceptualization ability is trying to guess who am I. And the moment it guesses, the non-duality becomes duality. And non-duality get twisted into...
It's peaceful, why did it want to find out it?
It is not... It has an ability. Now, sun, why sun has to give light?
It's the nature of
sun. The consciousness is peaceful all the time. But it has an ability called Lakshmi, who doesn't sit quietly. She keeps on conceptualizing what to do.
So it's like the light trying to understand the source.
Huh. The moment it does, it is a distortion. It can never be real.
Yeah.
So finally it will come to a stage, okay, in a realized person, oh, this is all is Maya, let me go back. Like that it will go back. So why the duality came is the universe tried, the consciousness tries to understand itself, not because it has a motivation, but because it's nature.
Okay.
There's no motivation for consciousness to do anything.
Okay.
Yeah?
So you gave that university example that when
this is the first question Prasad asked me when he met me. He got satisfied with my answer. He didn't get any answer.
So why did you said the universe is like a university where some students pass out, new students come in.
Right.
So when, let's say, one jiva dissolves into the consciousness, then a new jiva will come up.
There are millions of them. 64 million ants waiting to become. Deer is waiting to become tiger. Tiger is waiting to become human being.
So there are no new jivas forming.
There may be also. What is your problem? There is mineral kingdom. But you have a problem. You are not running the universe. Vishnu is running the universe. Vishnu is dreaming and he is running the university. What is your problem?
Okay, fine.
He will get bored if there are no students there. So let them come now.
He will create some new things. He
not new things. The mineral kingdom. The stone will be. Stone will start becoming life.
Yeah.
It's not ending.
Mm, continuous process.
It's a continuous process. Your job is whether you can graduate and get out or you sit and fail. That's also your job.
So how does something manifest?
The manifest is conceptualization. Conceptualization.
That again is a
conceptualization. You manifested Big Bang, no? You manifested atoms. molecules. Where is the atomic molecule? Have you seen anybody? Has anybody, any physicist seen atomic molecules?
Not with our naked eyes, but there are instruments.
But instruments also, can they see it? Or they are actually a conditioned reality you are viewing.
Yeah.
So there is no atomic molecule. You are trying to see it.
Yeah.
That's how you square.
We are able to see atoms and molecules.
Ask him. Don't tell me.
You probe, right? But that probing itself is another conceptualization.
Yeah.
You are there. It is there because you are seeing it.
Yeah.
Your ghost is there because you are thinking there is a ghost. They are creating atoms actually.
Thinking is created, Guruji.
That's how universe does. How atoms he can say. See, ultimately, universe has no job. So it keeps on creating. Scientists want some money. They'll create something else. Tomorrow you'll get into condensed matter, this thing. Something will come back. Okay, that you're creating. For your purpose is to get some money, make your living, have a marriage, have children, have a family, and possibly get a Nobel Prize. That's how life is. Then after next few generations, they'll believe Pranab has discovered a great thing. He's a great Nobel laureate. The theory will be there for 200 centuries. Then after that, another guy comes and says, I want a Nobel Prize. Then you disprove Pranab's theory and he'll come on. Einstein's theory will be relative theory. Is good, 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 good. After some time, somebody will come and say, no, it's not good. There's a problem in this. See, in the conceptualization, everything is a shadow. Okay? So have you seen the physics saying how the universe is a shadow? Have you seen the quotation?
No.
I noticed those quotations, okay?
Okay.
I'll just show you the quotations by the scientists. This way saying the frank realization that the physical science concerned with the world of shadows. Arthur Stanley Eddington.
Something
Okay, I'm missing it. The Arthur Stanley Eddington. He says, physics is chasing shadows. Actually, okay, you make a shadow out of that. The shadow is, looks nice, it's like a deer, it's like look at him. It's okay, but I'll tell you how our ancient rishis, what they did today. Hmm? Today I'm going to tell you about rishis, what they, how they discovered something. Okay. You have two questions, sir. The question number one, you know?
What is the message whether Kali
and Shiva?
Okay.
Then about the Sai Baba, the avatar Purusha, what exactly do you think he was?
I will not judge what Sai Baba is, right? I just say what
Shri
is the. No, I'm saying I will not tell anything about an individual. I'm telling you what difference is there between the Avatar Purusha and Avaduta. Her question is, what is the difference between the Avatar Purusha and Avaduta? Anta? Avatar Purusha and Avaduta are the same. Avatar Purusha, normally he is born enlightened. Jnaniya kutututare. Okay? And he is born with a body which has lot more powers than a normal human body. But deha samani human deha kinta jastiyada shakti irthadakke. Okay, for example, Shri Krishna is avatar purusha. That's the recognition of avatar purusha in India. Nammalli avatar purusha anta helidre it's equivalent of helidre prodigy anta helabodu. Prodigy anta child prodigy anta. Huttidagale avaru bahala brilliant agirtare. Okay? The brilliance comes from two aspects. One is papura janma karma. ಪೂರ್ವಜನ್ಮಕ್ಕೆ ಬ್ರಿಲಿಯಂಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಹಿಂದಿನ ಜನ್ಮ ಏನೋ ಮಾಡಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಈ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ದೇ ಔಟ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೇ ಗೆಟ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್, ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಕಮ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಪರ್ಶ್ಯೂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಂಬಡಿ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಮಿಲಿಟ್ರಿ, ಮಿಲಿಟ್ರಿ ಪರ್ಶ್ಯೂಟ್. ನನ್ನ ಮೈ ಡಾಟರ್ ವಾಂಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಆರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಆರ್ಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಸ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಪಾಸ್ ವಾಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಆರ್ಟ್. ದಿಸ್ ಫೆಲೋ ವಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗೋ ಟು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಅದು ಬಿಸ್ನೆಸ್ ವಾಸನ. ಸೊ ದೇ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಪೀಪಲ್. ಅದೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹಿಂದಿನ ಜನ್ಮದ ವಾಸನೆ ತಗೊಂಡು ಬರ್ತಾರೆ. ವೆರ್ ಆಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹೂ ಇಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ, ಓಕೆ, ಅವನೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೀ ಇಸ್ ಲಿಬರೇಟೆಡ್. ಅವರಿಗೆಲ್ಲ ಅವನ ವಾಸನೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದೆನ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯಕರ್ಮ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪಾಪ ಕರ್ಮ ವಿಲ್ ರಿಮೇನ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಹಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಸಂಚಿತ ಪಾಪ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ. ಸಂಚಿತ ಪಾಪ, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ. ಎಲ್ರಿಗೂ, ಎನಿ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಇ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ, ಅವನೇನಾಗುತ್ತೆ, ಸಂಚಿತ ಪಾಪ, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ, ಪ್ರಾರ್ಧ ಕರ್ಮ, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇರ್ತದೆ. ಪ್ರಾರ್ಧ ಕರ್ಮ ಹೋಯಿತು, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಅಪ್ ನಾವು. ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗ್ ಟು ಮಿ. ಅವ್ನು ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ನಂದಲ್ಲ. ದಿ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಹಿ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್, ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಗೋಸ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಹಿಮ್. ಪ್ರಾರ್ಧ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಬಟ್ ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸಿಪೇಟ್ ಆಗಲ್ಲ, ನಾಶ ಆಗಲ್ಲ. ಆ ಸಂಚಿತ ಕರ್ಮ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ರೀಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ರೀಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟೆಡ್. ಹಿಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಡ್ ಕರ್ಮ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹೂ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಆಬ್ಸ್ಟೇಕಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪಾತ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ಮೆನಿ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತದೆ. ಹಿಸ್ ನೆಗೆಟಿವ್ ಕರ್ಮ ಗೋಸ್ ಟು ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ದಿ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹೂ ಅಬ್ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್. ವೆರಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಗುಡ್ ಕರ್ಮ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು ಶಿಷ್ಯಾಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದೋಸ್ ಹೂ ಸೀಕ್, ಯಾರು ಸೀಕ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೋ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಐ ಗಿವ್ ಎನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಶ್ರೀ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ. ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿಜಿ, ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ಹಿ ಗೆಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಈ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ಅ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಹಿ ಸೆಟ್ಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ಮಂತ್ರಾಲಯ ಫಾರ್ 900 ಇಯರ್ಸ್. 900 ವರ್ಷ ಇರ್ತೀರಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದರು. ಓಕೆ, ಅಲ್ಲಿ 300 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಐ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ರೂಪ. ಅವರೇನು ಸಜೀವ ಸಮಾಧಿ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರು, ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ರೂಪದಲ್ಲಿರ್ತ ಅಂತ. ಅದರರ್ಥ ಅವರ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ಶರೀರ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ. ಸಟಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಡಿಡ್ನ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್, ಓನ್ಲಿ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್. ಸ್ಥೂಲ ಶರೀರ ಡಿಸಾಲ್ವ್ ಆಯಿತು, ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ಶರೀರ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ರು. ಅಂದರೆ ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮಂತ್ರಾಲಯ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಸಟಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸಟಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇನ್ಸ್ ದ ಮೈಂಡ್, ಬುದ್ಧಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರಾಣ. ಆ ಸೂಕ್ಷ್ಮ ಶರೀರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇದ್ದರು. ನಾವು ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡೂಯಿಂಗ್ ದೇರ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಫಾರ್ 300 ಇಯರ್ಸ್? ಹಿ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ. ಅಂದರೆ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಈ ಗಾಟ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್, ಸೋ ಮೆನಿ ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಇದ್ರೆ ಅದನ್ನು ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ.
It's not that he is giving new. It's not that he is giving vara, boon. His accumulation of punya is for 300 years. Can be distributed. Adi hagandre, a billionaire becomes a billionaire. Like for example, Bill Gates. Billionaire. He got a billions. Now he stopped his working. Now he says, okay, I'll do this charity. He is distributing now. Right? It happens in case of billions. After they achieve something, they'll start distributing. Srimanta, ತುಂಬ ದುಡ್ಡು ಬಂದರೆ ಈಗ ಬಿಲ್ ಗೇಟ್ಸು ಕಡೆ ವಾರನ್ ಬಫೆಟ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವರು ಅರ್ಧ ಆಸ್ತಿನ ಕೊಟ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಏನು ಮಾಡೋದು ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ಪೂರ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಈ ಜ್ಞಾನಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಕೂಡ ಅವರ ಆಸ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಪುಣ್ಯ ಈ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಬರಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವ ಅರ್ನ್ ಲಾಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಗುಡ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಆ ಪುಣ್ಯವನ್ನು ದಟ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ದೇ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಕಮ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ರಾಘವೇಂದ್ರ ಸ್ವಾಮಿ ಡಿಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 300 ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಬಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಓವರ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ But he doesn't want to stay there. So he wants to go, Sukshma Sharira, he wants to go out. Then he says, my punya is so much, the next 600 years I'll get it.
Even if I go.
So next 600 years is a, in human lifetime, it's actually about 80 years of life, really, 7 lifetimes. Entire life. And 7 lifetimes ಆ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಈ ಸ್ಟಿಲ್ ಇನ್ ಸ್ಟೋರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಯು ಆ 7 ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಅದನ್ನು ಜನರಿಗೆ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ಮುಂದೆ ಬರೋರಿಗೆ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಈ ಲೀವ್ಸ್ ಬೃಂದಾವನ ಆಯ್ತಾ ಆ 7 ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ವಾಟ್ ದೇ ಸೇ ಎ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಎ ಹಿಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋ ಟು 7 ಜನರೇಷನ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಆ 7 ಜನರೇಷನ್ಗೆ ಹೋಗೋ ಪುಣ್ಯವನ್ನು ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ 7 ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಹಾಂ
His
600 years.
Okay.
600 years is calculation of human life into 90 years.
Okay.
85 years. So, ashtu kala apunya distribute agutte. Aur papa enayito, the papa whatever sin which he had done is already got distributed to his enemies in many lifetimes. Punya is he is distributing.
Papa got distributed so fast.
Okay. So now that's what is sanchita karma enagutte sanchita karma kiga agutte. Whereas Buddha, people like Buddha, they took a vow of earning good punya to transform the entire universe. Till that time I'll get not mukti anta. Adike bodhisattva vow anta heltare, they call it the bodhisattva vow. Bodhisattva shapatha. Yena shapatha andre bodhisattva pratyanandre, nanu idi vishwada ella jeevigalige mukti marga torisuvarige nanu mukti beda nanu mukti beda anta. ಅಂದರೆ ಅಷ್ಟು ಗುಡ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಅರ್ನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸೊ ಬುದ್ಧ ವರ್ಕ್ ಫಾರ್ 500 ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅರ್ನ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮೆರಿಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಲೈಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಯಾವುದಕ್ಕೆ ಹಿ ಡಿಂಟ್ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎನ್ ಮುಕ್ತಿ 500 ಲೈಫ್ ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಹಿ ಅಕ್ಯುಮುಲೇಟೆಡ್ ಬಿಫೋರ್ ಹಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟ್ ಸೊ ನಾವು ಬುದ್ಧ ಡೈಟ್ ಬುದ್ಧ ಪಾಸಿಟಿವ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಎಷ್ಟೇ ನಾವು ಅಬೌಟ್ 4000 ಇಯರ್ಸ್
2500
ಇಯರ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಬಟ್ ಹಿಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ ಈಸ್ ಗೆಟಿಂಗ್ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಟ್ ನೌ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಓಕೆ So what happens is that before you get realization, you accumulate punya or papa. The punya gets distributed. Okay? Now that punya, what is distributed, can be used by the same being or not being, universe, to create another body for teaching. That's called avatara purusha. So avatara purusha will create a body of dharma. It's called dharma kaya. Okay? It's not individual now. The realized person has merged with the universe. ಆ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಏನಾಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಿಟಿ ಮರ್ಜಾ ಬಿಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಬಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಸೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೇಯಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ದೆನ್ ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಇಸ್ ದರ್ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ ಬಾಡಿ ಸಂಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಪಿಕ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ದ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪಿಕ್ ಅಪ್ ದ ಧಾರ್ಮಿಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ನಾವು ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ನೋ ಲರ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೈಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಸೊ ಸಚ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಸೊ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಎ ಕಾಸ್ಮಿಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಧರ್ಮ ಟು ಎಸ್ಟಾಬ್ಲಿಷ್ ಧರ್ಮ ಸಂಸ್ಥಾನ ಸೊ ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ಜ್ಞಾನ ಇಲ್ಲ ದ ಮೊಮೆಂಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ವಿತ್ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಮಗೆ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಆಗಿ ಹೇಳ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ಟು ಟೆಲ್ಲರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ವೆರಿ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ದೇ ಸೆಡ್ ಯಶೋದ ವಾಸ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೆಗ್ನೆಂಟ್ ದೆನ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಅಪಿಯರ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಟಾಕ್ ಟು ಹರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಕಮ್ಯುನಿಕೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಇಸ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಅದ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಇಸ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಅಂತ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಮೀನಿಂಗ್ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಬಾಡಿ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಇಸ್ ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ ಓನ್ಲಿ ನೋಬಡಿ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಜ್ಞಾನಿ ಆಸ್ ಮಜ್ಜು ಪರಮಾತ್ಮ Paramatma takes the universal raw material of dharma and creates dharmic cosmic body, which is very powerful. Okay, ಆ ಬಾಡಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ತುಂಬ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇರ್ತದೆ ಕಂಪೇರ್ ಟು ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬಾಡಿ, ನಾರ್ಮಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ. ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಗಾಟ್ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್, ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಕರ್ಮಕಾಯ, ವಿ ಗಾಟ್ ಎ ಬಾಡಿ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ಮ. ಬಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಬಾಡಿ ಆಫ್ ಧರ್ಮ, ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ. ಓಕೆ, ಕರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ಕರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಇಸ್ ಲಿಮಿಟೆಡ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ವಾಸನಾಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ, ನೀವೇನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ಅದು ಲಿಮಿಟ್ ಆಗಿರ್ತದೆ. ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಇಸ್ ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸ್ ಧರ್ಮ, ಯೂನಿವರ್ಸಲ್ ಧರ್ಮ ಇಸ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಎ ವೆರಿ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರಿಯೇಟೆಡ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವ್ ಅಧರ್ಮ. ಹಾಂ, ದಿಸ್ ನೋಡಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಅವತಾರ ಪುರುಷ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ, ಧರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಧರ್ಮ ಶರೀರ, ವೆರಸ್ ಇಂಡಿವಿಜುವಲ್ಸ್ ಕಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಕರ್ಮಕಾಯ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ಮ, ಕರ್ಮದಿಂದ ಶರೀರ ಪಡ್ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ. ನೋ ಸಿ, ಎ ರಿಚ್ ಮ್ಯಾನ್, ಓಕೆ, ಹೀ ಡೊನೇಟ್ಸ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಬಿಲ್ ಗೇಟ್, ನೌ ಹಿ ಬಿಲ್ ಗೇಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅನಿಲ್ ಅಂಬಾನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಅಂಬಾನಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಆಲ್, ದೇ ಡೊನೇಟ್ ಎ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಅರ್ನಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ದೇ ಡೊನೇಟ್, ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಡೊನೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಪುಣ್ಯ. ಯೆಸ್, ಬಟ್ ಟು ಗೆಟ್ ಟು ಡೊನೇಟ್ ಮೋರ್ ಯು ನೀಡ್ ಟು ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ರಿಚ್, ನೋ ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ನೌ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೇಕಿಂಗ್ ಅದು ಟಾಕಿಂಗ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ಆರ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟನ್ಡ್, ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ಡ್ ರಿಚಸ್. What?
This won't make much change.
No, no, this also will make change. That also will make change. But that change will be much larger. Right? So this is called different between dharmakaya. There's an avatara purusha. Avatara purusha, the sign of avatara purusha is shown even in the womb. Hotte magu hotte illiraginda that avatara purusha na lakshana kaantare. And avatara purusha, as a child itself, he starts showing lot of characteristics which are normal child doesn't show. Okay, that's why it said Buddha when he was born, he walked 7 steps and said Buddha hutti kodu 7 steps madadanta. It's only some allegorical way of saying that he's already a jnani. Amrutandamayi when she was born, she was sitting in Padmasana and said child. Okay, so these are all the way of saying that that they are all jnanis by birth. They don't need anything to
Buddha was a
jnani by birth. Yeah. Then he does sadhana to teach people. Otherwise people think that, oh, no, 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 it's not for me.
Then bodhi vrikshat kelagade realization agidha?
Adella yenandrappa, loka kalyanakke nimgondu makkalu ella maadi tolisbekalla. You have to show how to achieve and torsakke? Right? Amrita Mai said she was born enlightened. But she did sadhana to teach people what sadhana is all about. Ramakrishna Paramahansa is avatar purusha. He did sadhana to teach people what sadhana is about. Otherwise you think that, no, 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 it's God has come and done, it's for God, not for me and theater. So you have to do sadhana to teach world. So Amritanamayi, when she was born, it said that she sat in Padmasana and smiled. And they said, how true it is, we don't know. But another avatar purusha, they are by birth, some of the lakshanas will come. A brilliance. Okay, so avatara purushas are born with a dharmakaya, body of dharma, which is huge. Okay, and normally avatara purushas ididella yeldo karya kshetra is large, it's not local. Okay, andre the field of work is much larger. Okay, dodda kelasa martaru andre big activity happens through avatara purusha. Whereas a jnani, Osho, okay, Osho when he was born, okay, he didn't take mother's milk for 12 days. Tai hal kudilla, 12 days he didn't drink mother's milk. Then somebody asked him, why you didn't take 12 days mother's milk? Tai hal 100 days yak kudilla anta. He said, in the previous life I was a Buddhist monk, Buddhist sannyasi agidde nanu. I took a vrata for 21 days fasting, 21 divasa. Adralli I completed 9 days and died. So
balanced
21 days. I was not enlightened. So for enlightenment the 21 days sadhana was required. The moment I was born I completed it. So enagutte, you continue the awareness. Awareness irutade. These are all, one category, first category is muktas. Muktas go and meet, Muktas and merge with the Brahman, there's nobody. But Mukta's Dharmakaya can be used by another avatar purusha to come, and create the up for the society. Okay, that's one category. Second category is called Yoga Prashta. Osho is a category of Yoga Prashta. Yoga Prashta, last lifetime they did a sadhana, they just reached the gate of enlightenment. Mukti, incomplete. And some little bit work is pending. Okay? Adana Madi Mukspitta. That's called Yoga Prashta. Ramana Maharshi was a Yoga Prashta. So he had done sadhana, reached the level, just required small trigger to realize. That's called Yoga Prashta. Avarenagtare, these people, but Yoga Prashta, but such a, they are great beings. Hagabittu, their influence spreads. Whereas Avatara Purusha may take active role. A Siddha Purusha may not take active role. Okay? So, yenagutte Siddha Purusha andre, he has already Purujanma Samskara ide. Hindi Jana Samskara ide. He has already backlog of Purujanma. Avarenu martare, salpa edmadi effort madibidre, they'll get realization. So they are actually already done a lot of sadhana. Ega Siddha, Siddha and miracles alla. Okay. Siddha Purusha and they do. Now depending on their punya, depending on their sadhana, a residual prarabdha karma is there. For residual prarabdha karma shows, I mean, spreads across the world. Okay. So then people will come to them. This is another category, Siddha Purusha. They may also look like Avatara Purusha, but if their punya is so large, that it attracts so many people. Prarabdha karma. Right? They also, Siddha Purusha, just a little bit of spending for realization. He took incarnation. Realization happened, but the accumulated punya is so much that they appear like Avatara Purusha, almost. Aita? Kadege, then there is another category whose prarabdha karma, who got a realization, okay, but prarabdha karma didn't get over. So Buddha says, Buddha in Atare, the moment once you get an Atmadnana by a guru or by a teacher, you got an initiation from a guru or teacher, you have entered the stream of Mukti. Okay? Mukti Adnana ke Banbidira. So then it's a matter of time. It may be 7 lifetimes, okay, or 7 years, or 7 days, or 7 minutes, depending on your what is that? The blockage. So sometimes what will happen, in that lifetime they don't get it. But next lifetime they will again continue from where they are. They will not stop. So this is not Yoga Prashta. So they have not achieved. They may take 6 or 7 lifetimes to achieve. But already they have entered. Adhyanagite, Atmadnanada Margal Hobidare. It will take a couple of lifetimes to enter. This happened in case of Kanakadasa. Kanakadasa got Dana. But Mukti Ajanal Sigilarge. Mukti Sibakata, Inon Janma Bravagato. A residual karmaito. So next general Mukti Sitarge, Kanakadasa. Hage, bare category there. So, who is a Siddha Purusha, who is Avatara Purusha, we cannot make a judgment. Okay, a Siddha Purusha may come with a lot of punya, he may look like Avatara Purusha. Or Avatara Purusha may come with less powerful body, he may look like a Siddha Purusha. So, we cannot say who is Siddha Purusha, who is Avatara Purusha. But Avatara Purusha, they'll start showing miracles or power. Siddha Purusha will start showing this power after some time. Is it clear? Next question.
Kali.
Shiva and Kali. So I showed yesterday the Kali dancing on the body of Shiva. Okay. Shiva na mele Kali dance board. There actually, in reality, universe is nothing but Shiva and Shakti only. Jiva is an appearance, not real. Okay. The Shiva takes the form of a Jiva to experience the world. Shiva Jiva nagi rupa devartare. When the Jivanagi Rupate Mandaga, he forgets his own nature and he appears as Jiva. Because of experience, propensity of experience, Shiva takes the form of Jiva. Then what happens? He comes under the influence of Kala, time. Okay? So, to tell you that Shakti is wife of Shiva when he is Shiva, the moment he becomes Jiva, Shakti troubles him rather than the time. Shakti as Kala, he comes under the influence of Kala, Kali. Shivane Jiva, Jivane Shiva. Shivanagidre Shakti, Shivana control lide. Jivanagidre Shiva Shakti, Shiva Shakti control lide. ಅದೇ ಶಿವ ಶಿವಸ್ವರೂಪಿ ಆಗಿದ್ರೆ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್ ಆಯ್ತಾ. ನೌ ದಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ದ ರೋಲ್ ಹಿ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಜೀವ ಅಂಡ್ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ದ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಕಂಟ್ರೋಲ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಎ ಪ್ಲೇ ಆಫ್ ಶಿವ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರಕೃತಿ. ಶಕ್ತಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೋರ್ ಪವರ್ಫುಲ್ ದೆನ್ ಶಿವ. ಶಿವ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಜೀವ. In Chaitanya, Shiva is more powerful, Shakti is instrument. Any questions?
But in that, in mythology, historical part, whatever you call it, the story they show, they show that Shiva comes and falls at her feet to reduce her...
This is actually in the mythology, Adanna Hedo Riti. The essence of that, unless you go to spirituality, you can't understand the essence of that.
Yeah.
So mythology is for common man people to communicate.
Yeah.
Any story in Purana has to be interpreted in three ways. Adi Bhautika, Adi Daivika, Adhyatmika. Adi Bhautika, Adhyatmika, Adhyatmika. But Adhyatmika bandha, you can tell him. Or Shiva and Jiva, he is under trouble of Maya.
Okay.
Aita, next. Okay, so now today is more interesting topic for you people. Now this is actually, we came yesterday from Jnana point of view. Okay, ninne varige Jnana dinda mukti. Okay, ega yogic marga, yoga marga. Now here there is no, in the yoga marga, so they are not straight away going to liberation. You go in a gradual way. ನಿಧಾನವಾಗಿ ಹೋಗ್ತಾರೆ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ದ ಜರ್ನಿ. ಆಯ್ತಾ, ನಾನು ಸರ್ ಇನ್ ಹರಿ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ದ ಹೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಔಟ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆಲ್ ದಿಸ್? ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಮಿ ಗೆಟ್ ಟು ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ರೂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಪ್ರಾಬ್ಲಮ್, ಗೆಟ್ ಔಟ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾನಿ ಈಸ್ ಅಬೌಟ್. ವೈ ಬಾದರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ಟು ಮೆನಿ ನೈಸಿಟೀಸ್? ಪ್ಲಸ್ ಯೋಗಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಭಕ್ತ ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ನೈಸಿಟಿ, ದೇ ವಾಂಟ್ ಎಂಜಾಯ್ ದಿ ಪಾತ್. Our path is more important than destination most of the time, many times. Okay. In that case, what happens? Our yogi and bhakti are enjoying the journey. And many times they get stuck in the journey also, at various junctions. Okay. Today I am telling you a marga called Shakti Marga. Earlier was Shiva Marga. So that's earlier one was what I told you, Shambhavopaya. Shambhavopaya means path of Jnana. Path of Jnana is called Shambhavopaya. Now I have come down to Shakti Upaya, which is next level.